Hello, and welcome back to Eldritch Horror, The Dreamlands, Turn 5. Before we begin, I did have a question in the comments about whether this zombie should have actually spawned on the last turn. As you may remember, Kate Winthrop had used her special ability to discard the gate instead of spawning the gate. And in the rules, it says to when you spawn a gate, you draw a monster from your monster bag. And so instead of spawning, Kate Winthrop discarded it. So it kind of sounds like you are not supposed to spawn a monster when she uses her ability. I did find one forum on BoardGameGeek where they had kind of come to that conclusion. I didn't see anything official, but that's the way I'm going to play it. So this zombie did not actually spawn because Kate discarded the gate instead. So that's our only correction from last turn, and we will go ahead and get going. Okay, starting off this turn, Amanda Sharp will be our first investigator, and for Amanda's turn, she is going to travel to Space 17, where Daisy Walker was incapacitated, and hang out there in Space 17. And then for her second action, she is actually going to rest, and on her rest, she has a couple of things that she's going to do. So, Hypnos, again, says you can only recover sanity or health, so we're going to cover the one sanity from resting. That brings her from 4 to 5 sanity, her maximum is 6. In addition, she has this righteous condition. When you perform a focus or a rest, gain a focus or a sanity. Well, she's already got 2 focus, which is the maximum, but she can gain an extra sanity. Now, it would be more useful for her to have 1 health and 1 sanity, but again, Hypnosis condition says you can, when you rest, you can only gain sanity or health, and so I'm just going to gain 2 sanity, 1 from resting and 1 from the righteous condition. So that brings her back up to full sanity, which is 6. In addition, she also has this unspeakable research, which we've done a couple of times now. We have 2 Eldritch tokens on this. When you perform a rest action, you may delve deeper into the secrets of the Ancient Ones. Make an observation check. If you pass, place an Eldritch token on this card and then flip this card. All right, so let's try to do an observation test. Amanda's observation is a 4, so we're going to roll 4 dice here. And that one fell out, but we got a 6 anyway, so it doesn't matter too much. So, we're going to put another Eldritch token on this. The question is whether we want to flip this or wait one more round. On her next turn, our plan is to go back into the Dreamlands. So I think we're going to wait one more turn on this. So we'll put a 3rd Eldritch token. Here's the Eldritch token for the unspeakable research. And that's it for Amanda Sharp. Next up is Akashi Anyela. And so we'll go over to the Dreamland sideboard for Akashi. Okay, next up is Akashi Anyela, and the question was really, which investigator did I want to go over to the pyramids and do that expedition encounter, spend the clue so that we could solve the rumor? My initial plan was to have Amanda go over because she is only, she's 2 away, she can make it there next turn, or I can have Akashi do it because Akashi could travel to Ulthar here on her next turn, she could go to the underworld. And from the underworld, that's not true, she can't do it from the underworld. She could travel to the moon, and from the other sideboard, we have the moon in the heart of Africa, and from there she could move up to the pyramids. So I considered having Akashi do that instead. I think what we're going to have Akashi do, though, is we're going to have Akashi grab a talent condition, see what she can do, and we're going to let Amanda deal with the expedition and the rumor, so... as I thought it out, we went with that plan. So for her first action, Akashi is going to go from Dilath Lean to Ulthar as her travel action. And secondly, Akashi is actually going to trade with Gloria. Now the reason we're going to trade is because we have this hunting horror who is going to come out on another reckoning, and he is going to come after Gloria. Amanda over here on the main board is too far away to be the closest investigator now. So what we're going to do is trade the wither spell that Gloria has, and we're going to give that to Akashi so that when the hunting horror comes this way, probably next turn, it's possible it won't be next turn depending on if we get a green Mythos card or a rumor card. But if we get one with a reckoning, that hunting horror is coming after us. So we're going to let Akashi take care of the hunting horror. She has the highest will, and see if she can survive. Now, neither one of these investigators, Gloria and Akashi, have a lot of health and sanity. Gloria does have 4 health, 3 sanity. Akashi has 3 health, 3 sanity. So it's not great either way, but we're going to let Akashi deal with that hunting horror. So, as part of the trade, we're actually going to trade one clue from Akashi to Gloria. Actually, that's not true. We're not going to trade a clue. Keep the clue, Akashi. I was thinking that we're going to give Gloria a clue so that she can work on the active mystery, but I forgot for just a second that she has the Tome of Secrets, which is once per round she can spend a focus in place of spending a clue. So if she just focuses, she can use that as a clue once per round to work on the active mystery. So we're going to let her do that. So Akashi for her second action did a trade, and she's just going to take the Wither spell from Gloria. We're not going to trade anything else around. So that's it for Akashi. Next up is Kate. Okay, and here we are back with Kate. For Kate's turn, we're going to do a local path from Unknown Kadath over here to Sydney. So if you remember on Sydney, we have this Unknown Kadath dream portal. So as a local action, she's going to go from the Dreamlands back to the waking world in Sydney. And then from Sydney, she is going to grab a ship ticket for her first action. Here's her ship ticket. And for her second action, she's going to travel to space 20 and spend that ship ticket she just got to go to Shanghai. Now the reason we're going to Shanghai, it's kind of difficult to tell, but the next gate coming up is Shanghai, so we're going to try to do the same gate trick again and have Kate prevent gates from opening up. So that is Kate's turn. Next up is Gloria Goldberg. And Gloria's already here in the shot, and she's delayed. So for her turn, she is just going to be flipped around, and she is now not delayed anymore. So that's it for the investigator's turn. Let's go to the encounter phase. Okay, here we are in the encounter phase, starting with Amanda Sharp. Now Amanda's going to have an encounter on Daisy Walker's space. So here is Daisy Walker's card, and we're going to see what happens here. In case of crippling, injury, or death, Daisy is pleased when you come to visit. She tells you to help yourself to her book and her other gear. Gain all of her possessions. Well, that is excellent news, because Daisy had a lot of possessions. She had this clue, this Five of Pentacles. When you gain this card, improve influence. I believe that that still applies to Amanda, so we're going to grab an influence. For Amanda. That actually puts her influence from 3 up to 4. Now, some of the other cards say when you gain this, like the Book of Spells, when you gain this card from the deck of the reserve, then you don't get the extra spells. But this one just says when you gain this card. Kind of seems like if you pass that around, you could improve everybody's influence. I haven't thought too much about that as a tactic, but that's an interesting idea. Anyway, so he has this Five of Pentacles, this old journal, test observation. If you pass, you might find something that's useful. That's great, because Amanda's observation is really good. She has the Arcane Insight as an action. She can test lore minus 2 and give someone a clue. Amanda's not a great spellcaster, but we'll see. She does have the Chief Inspector, which raises her observation even more. The Astral Travel, when you perform a travel, you can spend a sanity to move one space along any path, which is great. She has that Book of Spells, like we mentioned, so she's not going to get any additional spells. But she does get the plus 2 on her lore now. And last, the Holy Cross, plus 2 will during combat encounters. So we're going to give all of this over to Amanda Sharp. Amanda now has 7 clues. She has all of the clues. Let's get back to this. Okay, she says there was one book brought to her after she lost her sight. But she'll need your help to explain its contents. Make a lore check. All right, so her lore. Amanda's lore is a 2. Did we get anything that will help us during that? No, we have a +2 lore for spell effects, but we don't have anything else. We do have 2 focus and 7 clues, but let's see what happens here. That is not a pass. So let's spend one of our focus. And we're going to re-roll one of these dice. That's a 5. That's a pass. All right, let's take it. Let's see what happens here. She'll need your help to explain its content. Test lore. If you pass, the text and its usage are clear to you. Gain 1 tome artifact. Okay, well that's good. I was hoping to retreat Doom, but I guess we will take a tome artifact. And if you fail, bad stuff happens. Whether you pass or not, discard her investigator token. So, goodbye Daisy Walker, the librarian. Okay, here we've got our artifact deck. Just give it a little shuffle. And we're going to go until we find a tome. That's not a tome. Not a tome. Not a tome. There we go. Item tome. Massa de Requiem per Shuge. Item, test lore -1. If you pass, you may spend 1 sanity to discard 1 monster on a space of your choice containing a gate. On a reckoning, roll a die on a 1, advance doom by 1. Yeah, we don't want this card. Ugh. I mean, I like discarding monsters, but doom is already in a bad way. That's what we got, so we'll give that to Amanda Sharp. It does help her her spell, though. She gets +1 lore die for each tome she has, and she has a few tomes now. Okay, here we are in Ulthar with Akashi, and so we're going to do an Ulthar encounter. Trying to get some talents so we can pass that active mystery. Says, the village soothes your spirits. Recover 2 sanity. Hey, that's actually really good. Probably won't be able to get a talent now because they already gave us something good. Alright. Seeing that this dream is pleasing, the Lord of Sleep offers to improve it in exchange for 1 year of your life. If Hypnos is the Ancient One, and he is, you may spend 1/2 of your health to gain a blessed condition. Ooh, that is kind of tempting. I needed a talent condition. We didn't get one. I would lose 2 health, but Akashi would become blessed. Let's just look at this hunting horror, because we know it's coming after her. If she lost any health, she would need at least 2 successes on her combat. She would be dead, blessed or not. No, I don't think we're gonna do it. I think that hunting horror is too tough. Although it'd be easier to fight with a blessed condition. But we'll say no. Okay, that's it for Akashi. Next up is Kate Winthrop. Okay, here we are in Shanghai with Kate Winthrop, and we are going to do a Shanghai encounter. So we'll see what happens here. A man with a loudly ticking watch offers to help you in exchange for spying on the Communist Party. You know, the guy with the ticking watch never has anything good. You may gain a dark pack condition to improve 1 skill of your choice. If you don't gain the condition, the well-dressed man warns you that he's always watching. Gain a paranoia condition. I don't want a dark pact. Improving a skill of my choice would be nice. We don't need to improve a skill, though. No, we're not going to take the Dark Pact. So here's our Madness deck. And we'll just draw off the bottom here until we find a Paranoia. There it is, paranoia. I think we've seen this one already. When you perform a rest action, you may roll one die. On a 5 or 6, discard this card. On a reckoning, test will. If you fail, flip the card. Kate's will is not great. It's only a 2. Let's see if we can get a way to get rid of that, though. Okay, that's it for Kate. Last up in the encounter phase is Gloria Goldberg. Okay, we're back in Ulthar with Gloria Goldberg. Surely we can get a talent condition now. So we're going to do an Ulthar encounter. As you read the temple's copy of the Narcotic Manuscripts, you start to go mad. Make a will check. Okay, Gloria's will is a 3. It's pretty good. She doesn't have any focus or clues or anything that improves her will, though, so we're going to have to hope we get lucky. Two sixes. All right. If you pass, you learn valuable lessons, gain one talent condition. If you fail, bad stuff happens. All right. We finally got a talent condition. I'm so excited. Now we can close a gate, spend a clue, drop our talent condition. Here we go. Get going on this mystery. Mystery isn't going to wait for us forever. So here's our talent deck. And we'll see what we get. We have Headstrong. Once per round, when you would lose sanity, you may test Will. If you pass, prevent the loss of up to 2 sanity. I really wish Akashi would have got that, because we got that Hunting Horror coming after us. But we gave it to Gloria. Gloria won it fair and square. It's all hers. Okay, that's it for the encounter phase. And up next is the Mythos phase. Okay, here we are in the Mythos phase. Amanda Sharp is our first investigator. She'll be the one drawing this card. And we get... Ooh, Glimpse the Lurker. That doesn't look like a good one. Alright, Omen Movement. So, it's hard to see the omen from this camera angle, but it's moving from blue to green. Do we have any green gates on the board? No. We have a red gate in the Himalayas. We have a red gate in the heart of Africa. And those are all of our gates, so no doom yet. We have a reckoning, so let's check all of our monsters first to see if they have any reckoning effects. We actually don't have any monsters on the main board. We do have 2 cultists. The cultists don't have any reckoning effects. We do have this crazed mob on Celephaeus, and roll a die on a 1 or 2, advance doom by 1. This is going to be the death of us. Okay, here we go. 4, we'll take it. Okay, the other one is we do have the Hunting Horror, and he says, move this monster to the nearest space containing an investigator, then investigator on that space immediately encounters it. So, interestingly enough, he could go to the Himalayas right here, because it is connected via one space to the underworld, but because there's no one there, the closest investigator is going to be over here in Ulthar. So, let's go over to the Dreamlands. Okay, here we are in the Dreamlands, and this Hunting Horror said, move this monster to the nearest space containing an investigator, and then an investigator on that space immediately encounters it. So we're going to have Akashi encounter it, because it does say an investigator on that space. And so Akashi's will is a 4, and she's going to make a -1 check, so she'll be rolling 3 dice, and... she needs at least 3 successes to prevent losing any sanity. Akashi does not have... She has 2 clues, but she doesn't have anything else. Okay, our 6 was kind of out of frame there, but we did get 1 success. That means Akashi loses 2 health. Fortunately, she gained 2 health before. Oops. Or 2 sanity in her encounter phase. Next is the Strength... We're going to need 2 successes to prevent taking damage and 3 successes to actually kill him. So let's see what we can do. Kashi has the Wither spell. We're going to use that. And it says, when resolving a combat encounter, you may test Lore. If you pass, gain +3 strength during that encounter. So Kashi's will is 3, or sorry, her lore is 3. So we're going to cast this spell and get a success. We got 2 successes. All right, we'll flip this and see what happens. That was good news. Okay, on a 0, we get an illness condition. On a 1, we lose a health. On a 2, your target's body withers into a weakened shape. Reduce the monster's damage by 1 to a minimum of 1. All right, that's pretty good. That means his damage goes down from a 2 to a 1. So we only need 1 success to prevent him from hitting us. Now I'm starting to think maybe I should have taken the health damage and gotten a blessed condition. It's all right. This was good. So Akashi's strength is 2. We're going to get the +3 from Wither. So we're going to roll 5 dice. And we're looking for 1 success to prevent getting damaged, or 3 successes to actually kill the thing. She does have 2 clues. We got 2 successes. Ooh, that is tempting to try to spend a clue to re-roll one of those. I don't think I'm gonna do it though. I'm worried I'm gonna need the clues for the mystery. I don't love that he's gonna keep chasing us around though. Yeah, we're not going to spend the clues. So, 2 health on the hunting horror. And that's that monster. I believe that's all the monsters. So next is Hypnos. Hypnos says, each investigator moves 1 space toward the nearest space on the Dreamland sideboard unless he spends a sanity. Well, these 2 are already on the Dreamland sideboard, so they will move to the nearest space, which is the space they're on, so nothing happens with them. Kate Winthrop, the closest way for her to get to the Dreamlands is actually go here to the Himalayas. We don't want her to do that, however, because we haven't spawned the gate yet, and it would ruin what we're trying to do. So Kate's going to spend her sanity. She's down to 6 out of a maximum 7. And Amanda Sharp over here on Space 17 has the same choice of going to the underworld as well. Unfortunately, we need her to get to the pyramids, which is 2 spaces away. So we're going to let Amanda take the sanity hit as well. Next are rumor cards. Discard an Eldritch token from this card. We had 3 of them here, and we're going to discard 1 and get down to 2. We did already get 1 clue on this thing, though. So there's the 2. Here's our discarded Eldritch token. Okay, and last we have investigator conditions and possessions. So let's go over to the investigator table. Okay, here we are with the investigators, starting with the lead investigator, Amanda. She has her pile of clues over here and a gigantic amount of assets. First one is the righteous condition. It says you may flip this card. We are not going to flip this card right now. I think we're going to wait for the circumstances to get just a little bit more dire. Next up, however, we are going to do the Massah de Requiem per Shuge. On a reckoning, roll a die. On a 1, advance doom by 1. So let's get a 5. How about a 5? I like 5s. It's a 6. There we go. So that's good. Last for her, she does have the astral travel, which says test lore and flip this card. So her lore is a 2. She has a +2 when resolving spell effects, so that makes a 4. Does she have anything else? I don't see anything else. So we're rolling four dice.
She does have that focus and a pile of clues.
We got one success. All right, well, let's flip it and see what happens. Okay, on a zero, you've been lost in the void. Move to random space unless you discard this card. On a one, traveling the void has put great strain on your mind. Lose one sanity. On a two, you can get rid of a detained condition or pursuit condition. Okay, yeah, we have seen this before.
So, one sanity from Amanda Sharp, unfortunately.
But that's all of her conditions. Next is Akashi, that doesn't have any. Next is Kate Winthrop, and she does have this paranoia condition. Test will. If you fail, flip the card. So Kate has three clues, and her will is a two. Good enough. It's a six. Okay, so we don't flip the card.
Okay, Gloria has her Find Gate spell.
It just says test lore and flip this card. And she got two successes. Wow. And we've seen this one before as well. You can read much from the stars. Reveal each gate in the gate stack. Well, that's already been done, so nothing happens. On a one, though, she'll lose a sanity unless she discards this card. Okay, that's it for the reckoning effects. Let's go back to the main board. All right, here we are on the main board to finish up our Mythos card. And we need to spawn a gate. So we have Shanghai. It was already turned face up, so we knew exactly where that was going. It's going to go on the Shanghai space. And Kate's ability says, if a gate would spawn in your space, discard that gate and gain a clue instead. So we're going to discard this gate. And gain this clue. And then our dimensional study. Once per round, when a gate is closed or discarded, you may spend one clue to place one clue on this card. Then you may flip this card. I've got two clues on it so far. I think we're going to wait a little bit longer. maybe we'll get three or four clues on here. I'll feel really good about that. Okay. And the actual text. In one horrifying moment, you saw the true nature of space between worlds. Now your mind stretches, twists, and shudders as you struggle to grasp the eternity of existence. Glimpse the lurker event. The lead investigator loses all but one sanity.
All right, Amanda Sharp loses three sanity.
So there's her three sanity.
Is there a way I can prevent that? No, Gloria had that headstrong condition. Yeah, I don't think there's any other way she can prevent it.
And if she lost less than five, she impairs lore, influence, and will.
So we're going to get a minus one lore.
So here's a minus one lore for Kate. She had a plus one influence, so she'll discard that token. And what was the last one? Will.
Will. That's no good.
So here's her minus one will. That's a pretty bad card. But that's the end of turn five. What are we going to do next turn? Well, I think the first thing we're going to do is have Amanda grab a train ticket, head over to Istanbul and the pyramids, do the expedition encounter, spend a clue, fix and finish this rumor right here. Kate, the next gate, actually, as you can probably see, is San Francisco. Unfortunately, San Francisco is 3 spaces away from Kate, so she's not going to be able to make it unless we have someone give her a ship ticket or something else. Yeah, I'll have to think about if there's a way I can figure out how to get Kate over to San Francisco. Akashi and Gloria are over here in Ulthar. And Gloria finally has a talent. And the Underworlds down here has a gate. We'll probably send Gloria down to solve that gate. And try to get the mystery going. Not sure what Akashi is going to do. So, yeah. That's it for turn 5. Thanks for sticking with me. If you have any questions or comments or you saw anything that I played wrong, feel free to let me know in the comments. And hopefully you'll join me again for turn 6. Thanks for watching.